way to Manchester. A lot of questions about how this is working in practice, about restrictions and how they will apply. So that's Andy Burton speaking to us in the next few minutes.
Now, 15 charities have joined forces. They're urging the government to protect the jobs of some workers who have been shielding due to the easing of the shielding system in Northern Ireland from today and in England and Scotland from tomorrow. Shielders will no longer receive medical advice to stay at home and will be able to go back to work, but charities say that some don't feel ready. The government says employers must discuss the best way for a safe return. Well, in Northern Ireland, the changes to shielding advice could affect around 80,000 people. We can talk to our Ireland correspondent, Chris Page. Chris, take us through what's been happening, because there's obviously been some reaction to these changes.
Yeah, that's right. It's a significant day for the more than 80,000 people who've been shielding for 4 months, because they have the sort of health conditions that mean they're particularly vulnerable to the coronavirus should they get it. Though there is also a sense of anxiety and nervousness amongst many of those people. It's been a long time since they... So doctors, politicians, scientists, they're all saying that if you are in that position, well, you should take it easy, do what you're comfortable with. Nobody's saying you have to come out today, so take things at your own pace. And also, the likes of the Northern Ireland Chief Medical Officer, Dr. Michael McBride, has been saying this morning, it's very important that for people who haven't been shielding, who are now well used to being out and about outside their own homes, for them to take extra care today, bearing in mind that the people they are walking past in the street, the people that they are seeing in shops, might be people who have been shielding. So it's all the more important to keep your social distancing rules and also to wash your hands, follow all the guidelines that we're now well used to.
Chris, okay, we've got this contact tracing app, haven't we, that's launching in Northern Ireland today. Interesting that it's launching where you are, considering it was tried and really let go when it was trialled in England.
Yeah, that's right. The app is being officially launched here today, but actually it is already downloadable from the likes of the App Store and Google Play. I've got it on my phone, for example. It's called Stop COVID NI. After you answer a few questions about privacy and that kind of thing, well, then you more or less don't need to do anything else except keep your Bluetooth function on. And that means whenever you go out and about, the app on your phone is linking up with the app on other people's phones. If one of those people then tests positive for coronavirus, well, then they let the app know, they upload their test results, then you get a message, a notification saying that you've been in contact with someone with the virus and therefore you're at risk of having the virus yourself. So far, thousands of people have downloaded it. As you say, this is happening here ahead of the rest of the UK. There's already an app on the go in the Republic of Ireland, has been for a few weeks, and this app here in Northern Ireland is actually designed by the same company, and the apps do communicate with each other, because plenty of people here, of course, cross the border into the Republic of Ireland on a regular basis. So key to how effective this app will be, and you can expect to hear lots about this today, is how many people will download it. So the message will be, if you don't have it, do get it on your phone as quickly as possible.
Chris, always good to talk to you. Thanks very much, Chris Page, there for us in sunny Belfast.
Let's have a look at the situation in Wales. Children under 11 years old no longer need to keep their distance from other people outdoors. It's part of the changes to lockdown rules being introduced next week.